wisest was Sir Thomas Tommy, multiplied as far as four, and knew what nine was taken from to make 11. He could write a letter to another knight. No other knight in all the land could do the things which he could do. Not only did he understand a way to polish swords, but knew what remedy a knight should see, whose armor had begun to squeak. And if he didn't find too much, wasn't that he didn't care for blips and buffetings as such, but felt that it was hardly fair to risk by frequent injuries a brain as delicate as his. His castle Tom was set conveniently on a hill, and daily when it wasn't wet, he paced the battlements until some smaller knight who couldn't swim should reach the moat and challenge him. Or sometimes feeling full of fight, he hurried out to scour the plain and seeing some approaching knight, he either hurried past, blew a triumphant trumpet blast. One day when good Sir Thomas Tom was resting in a handy ditch, the noises he was hiding from, though very much the noises which he always hid from before seemed somehow less, or was it more? A trotting horse, the trumpet's blast, the whistling sword, the armor's squeak, these and especially the last had clattered by him all the week. Was this the same, or was it not? Something was different, but what? Sir Thomas raised a cautious ear and listened as Sir Hugh went by, and suddenly he seemed to hear, or not to hear, the reason why this stranger made a nicer sound than all other knights who lived around. Sir Thomas watched the way he went, his rage was such he couldn't speak. For years they'd called him down in Kent the knight whose armor didn't squeak. Yet here and now he looked upon another knight whose squeak had gone. He rushed to where his horse was tied, he spurred it to a rapid trot. The only fear he felt inside about his enemy was not how sharp his sword, how stout his heart, but as he got to long a star. So he was singing, hand on hip, when something sudden came along and caught him a terrific blip right in the middle of his song. A thunderstorm, he thought, of course, and toppled gently off his horse and said the good Sir Thomas Tom, dismounting with a friendly air, allow me to extract you from the heavy armor that you wear. At times like these, the bravest knight may find his armor much too tight. 100 yards or so beyond, the scene our brave sir used to feed, Sir Thomas found a useful pond, careful not to wet his feet. He brought the armor to the brink and flung it in and watched it sink. So ever after, more and more, men of Kent would proudly speak of Thomas Tom of Appledore, the knight whose armor didn't squeak, whilst you, the knight who gave him bear, squeaks just as badly as the rest.